Willkommen. Departing for expedition. Over. Mission goal. All data looks beautiful. Channel's clear. Over.
Armstrong. 1969. Apollo 17, 1972. Mission Control Discovery Mode. Audi. Quattro.
Is Audi giving the first car going to the moon, or?
Yeah, yes, they are.
Robert.
Hey, hello, Robert.
Guys, whoever is outside, please come inside, because this is going to be interesting. We are finishing with a futuristic view, but not that much, because in end of 2019, will be the first launch to moon.
Yes,
Robert,
first private mission.
Space Tech, we are excited to hear the story. Thank you.
Can I get the clicker?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to the last talk of the day. I'm happy that all of you are still there. So the video that you just seen, it's an advertising, and it's something completely new. You know, advertising for space, you don't see that every day. And it's actually an advertising done together with the European Space Agency, something which was never been done before. And it's real. That's even more cooler than that. So we really want to send that little car that you've seen there to the moon. But first of all, who are we? So very quickly, PT Scientists, that's the company that we are, is a private space company which is focused on developing infrastructure technology. So we transport things into space. So if you have something right now sitting on your desk that you want to send to space, we are the guys getting it there. So we bring space things into the orbit of the moon, onto the surface of the moon, or all the way back to the Apollo landing sites. That's where we're going with our first mission, end of 2019. And we're a private company operating out of Berlin, Germany, where we right now have 65 employees, so quite a lot, and we're 10 years old by now. So I started the company with 6 scientists and engineers, friends in the beginning 10 years ago. And just have to check, okay, so I think the other thing which might be interesting, but I will come to that, is a very special thing is that we've been always been combining access to space from the commercial side, also with kind of media. So we also want to do media outreach, and that's something which is also things we're not just offering a service, we're also helping people to talk about it, to communicate it, something which you might have noticed a little bit with the video. That's where the partnership with Red Bull comes from. So itself, why is space so interesting? So of course, for me, I'm excited about space ever since I've seen Star Trek as a kid. So that's kind of what fascinated me. I'm too young to have like an Apollo moment. So I didn't see Neil Armstrong step on the moon, which really, really inspired many people. But for me, kind of the vision of science fiction, of technology, enabling the future of humanity. That is kind of what always excited me. That's also what excited people like Elon Musk. You know, he's also too young for Apollo. So science fiction, it is what kind of drives the motivation for today. And it's not just science fiction that we're talking about. We're talking about real market happening right now. And the interesting thing is what you can see that over $10 billion have been invested just in the private space industry in the last 3 years alone. So that is a sector, if you look at it, it's quite literally taking off right now. And you can see it that a whole lot of people are coming into the field which you would have not normally believed. For example, Jeff Bezos, the founder of Amazon, he's the strongest investor right now from the private side with Blue Origin bringing into the game. So there's a lot of movement happening there on the smaller scale with companies like us providing services, but also on the larger scale with big tech entrepreneurs kind of driving the race. And our company itself, as I said, we are 65 employees in Berlin. So we are mostly focused on the technical side. So we are a science and engineering company, something which we just did recently. And by the way, what I can also point out here is that we are, of course, always hiring. So if you know any good COO, CFO, or engineer who might be interested in space, send them our way. So the point is that our company is mostly engineering focused. So what we do is we really build spacecrafts. In our facilities in Berlin, we have 2,200 square meters where we have office facilities and laboratories where we build real hardware. And I will hand something around. I think that's a good suitable moment for that. Just please pass it on. This is one of the real parts of, and that is what you will never see in the public, actually. If you notice the wheels of the rover in the video, they looked a little bit different. This is the wheel, how it will be used on the moon. It's a very special material, and I hope that it gets passed around and that it gets back in the end. So that is 3D printed aluminum. So that's a very lightweight, very strong material, and that it helped us to get the weight, the mass of the rover down to less than 20 kilograms. So that is quite nothing. So it's really just the batteries and the electronics. And we're using a lot of cool high-tech material, which we developed together with partners and which we then bring into our products and, of course, also offer as products on their own. So that is the cool thing about space. Space is always cutting edge. You just have to make the challenge that cutting edge does not mean that it's ridiculously expensive like in the past. You know, if you think about the Apollo program, there is an estimate that the entire Apollo program, just one mission, costed around $35 billion back then in the 60s. You know, what $35 billion translates from the 60s to today, I don't know. I don't want to know that number. So it could be quite expensive. So we really want to make space exploration accessible to everyone. And that is by kind of bringing down the cost and by using technology which every one of us can use today. So just to give you a picture of our team, I think that is quite nice. It's just something which we did last week ago, so also nobody has seen that picture already. We actually decided to not wear any business dress. So that shows you a little bit that we have quite a young team, but we have a whole lot of, how to put it, senior advisors, so people who have really the, I don't have a chart on that. So we have a whole lot of people who come from the space industry, who help us, and also people who come from the normal industry who kind of help us get the connection into offering our products to kind of everyday companies. So something which is kind of special about us, it's one thing where we're quite good at, is actually bringing non-space entities into the space field. So for example, with Audi, that's a good example, you know, kind of enabling them to bring the first Quattro to the moon. That is a real serious thing. So there's this real technology which really makes sense, which benefits their hardware here on Earth. But I can give you another very cool example, and that is something which you already have in your pockets today, and that is 4G communication. So what we do is, and we actually already developed and have that ready, we developed a base station, which is the size of a pack of milk, and I don't know if the UK milk packs are the same as the German ones, so that example might not work, but it's like this, very small, very lightweight, low power, and it's a base station for the moon. So literally, once we land there on the moon, end of next year, you can go there, visit it, you know, and then take out your phone and, yeah, call home, for example. So that is something which is quite unique. That means that we're enabling communication on the moon with everyday technology, with things which are already established. If you want to build something for the moon and you do want to do communication, you can just use what you already have. You can develop it, prototype it, and use it right away. That's a very special thing. Normally for space, everything is kind of customized. People and NASA, for example, has a tendency to, not in a negative way, but if NASA were to build a communication link for the moon, then we would definitely build the best communication link that you can imagine. You know, but the only problem is it would be probably the most expensive one and one that nobody else would use, because anybody else would then build his own version of the best communication link. And that's really not how businesses work and can grow. So having a standard technology is quite nice. So LTE is a really good example for that. Also, it confronts us with very challenging problems. And that is actually that we offer a number of services like communication and data on the moon, but we really don't know what to charge people for that. You know, what do you charge for the first phone call on the moon? And, you know, what about roaming charges? So there's a whole lot of topics which kind of we need to figure out. The point is that there's a very strong demand. Just 2 weeks after we published in March this year, the fact that we are going to send a 4G base station to the moon, we got the two largest space agencies in the world asking us for the license of the technologies for their missions. So that shows that people really understand and see the value in it. It's not that they wouldn't have figured it out from themselves, but it's kind of a unique thing. We have something we're quite proud of. Just quickly, so what do we do mostly? So basically what we have is the spacecraft, which is called ALENA. ALENA is the Autonomous Landing and Navigation Module. And that's also the first time that it's a spacecraft with a female name. So it's not the Mighty Eagle or the Griffin, but something more modern also in that case. And the Audi Luna Quattro, that's the rover that we're bringing there next year. so to explore the Apollo landing site. And then we have even a smaller vehicle for lower cost options when we just want to deploy a base station and not just bring rovers and everything along. So what it looks like when Alina touches down is something which you can also see quite nice. It's a very short animation, but that is basically the touchdown of a spacecraft with no audio because you cannot hear anything in space. But yeah, this is where all the rovers are on, where the base station is on, and then when it basically will stay on the moon. That's what it looks like in our laboratory, for example. It's one of the earlier prototypes. And this is actually a spacecraft. It's not just something that we built in our basement, but something which has been in space many, many times before already, because the design has been copied over from an existing spacecraft. So some from the what is called as the autonomous transfer vehicle, a spacecraft which has been docked to the International Space Station. So we're using a design which has been quite proven. And yeah, basically, the thing that we do is focusing on infrastructure technology. So providing services that might be of use to others. I mentioned the cellular network, but it's also things like GPS for the moon or surviving the lunar night, which is quite challenging. And the thing that we are currently doing is for the first time also, we're still, and that is kind of surprising for many, after 10 years, a fully privately owned company. I own the majority of shares and I have a second CEO. And something which we do right now is because we want to pre-finance the second mission already that we do, is that we're actually looking on for money on the capital market. That might be quite interesting here for the audience. And then I have one more video which I want to show. I know it's 10 seconds, but this video is just 1 minute, so can I? No, I don't want to keep the people from getting home. But the last video is quite nice because it shows something special, and I just want to say it up front, because we're doing something which is not normal for space. Space is Star Trek, is to boldly go where no man has gone before. We're not doing that. We're for the first time ever, next year, we want to go back to a place where humanity has been before. So, and that is something which is truly exciting, and we thought about, if you have something exciting, why not let's share it with the world? But how do you do it? Yeah, you ask the guys from Red Bull. And that's what we did. And we teamed up with Red Bull, and they're helping us kind of communicate it to the world.
Five decades ago, we witnessed one of the boldest feats in human exploration. Now, the time is right for a new age of explorers. Humankind's greatest adventure is ready for its next step. The first private mission to land on the moon. In 2019, PT scientists, led by the visionary pioneer Robert Burmer, will make one giant leap in lunar exploration. Supported by some of the world's leading technology partners, this unmanned mission will explore the site of the last human mission and establish a permanent 4G network for future lunar explorers. Red Bull Media House, exclusive global media partner, will bring you a unique 360-degree experience throughout the mission with live, real-time HD images from the surface of the moon. Engage the world's imagination across broadcast, mobile, and social media. Join us in 2019 for the next mission to the moon.
Yeah, that's it. And I really hope that you join in next year. And yeah, if you're interested to also get in touch with our company, just reach out to us. Thank you very much.